Welcome to Excellent Families. So for those who don't know me, I'm going to introduce myself real quick. My name is Natasha Paris. I am a mother, I'm a wife, I'm an entrepreneur, and I'm your servant CEO and a lover of His presence. And I'm here to serve this community because I am passionate about families. And I feel like if we can intentionally build on the family, teach families how to live with those four pillars we talk about, which is spiritual, mental, financial, and physical, we will have that abundant life and build some amazing families all over the world. So that's why we're here. So tonight we have Jess. So Jess, it is so good to be connected with you. When I first saw you and I heard you speak, I was like, wow, you know, because I'm always looking to, you know, have amazing people around me, you know, because it's all about just having that positive, you know, vibe, the tribe around you. And as soon as I saw you, you were in Chisette Cowan's community. I was like, oh my gosh, I have to reach out to her because, I mean, just by you speaking, you blessed me so much. And so thank you so much for joining us tonight. And so we're going to get right into it. So I would just like for you to, you know, just share your excellent family with us.
Yes. Well, thank you for having me, Tasha. I really appreciate you just welcoming me into your community. I know how big that is just to open up your platform. And so I love what you're doing within Excellent Families. It's just such a beautiful, amazing community. And, you know, I've been married to my husband for almost 9 years. We have three beautiful children under five. Wow. And we've got one more on the way in October, October.
Oh my
God. So we will have four under six, which I'm very excited about, a little nervous about, but I'm more excited than nervous. That's a good thing. And just really, I love my babies. They're all very close, all 2 years apart. I have a 5, 3, and 1 year old, and they keep me busy, but they are there for my life. So I just love them to death. So yeah, that's my family. Yeah, I just am so blessed.
That is so awesome. You truly are blessed. For you to be able to have three children under age of five and to look the way that you look, and you're pregnant now. My goodness, you guys, throw some emojis in the comments for Jess, because that is seriously amazing. Like, people call me a supermom, but I think she has taken my crown. Okay, you have it. Okay, you are truly a supermom. All right, so Jess, tell us, who is Jess Winnett? Win in it to win it. Who is Jess Winnett?
Yes. I am, you know, it's funny because I'm in my 30s now, but I've been an entrepreneur all my adult life. I actually was raised by an entrepreneur. You know, my grandpa was an entrepreneur, my dad was an entrepreneur. I've been raised in that. And I remember even from a young age, my dad saying, you know, Jess, it's not the money is the root of all evil, it's the love of money is the root of all evil, you know? And so he said that money can be used as an amazing tool in your hands, and that you have the opportunity when you're given money to be more generous, you have more choices. And so I was very, you know, young when I was learning these principles about money. Unfortunately, mm-hmm. I had to learn the hard way, as I know many people do. Mm-hmm. My husband and I got into a lot of debt and learned the hard way that way, and just really struggling a lot of our marriage. And we got married young. My husband was only 19 when we got married. I was 23. So we were young. And so, you know, we were definitely, you know, just trying to survive and mm-hmm. living paycheck to paycheck, as I know a lot of young couples are.
Right.
And, you know, unfortunately, because of that, we just really were suffering in the way that, you know, what I want to save a lot of people from.
Yes.
And because we weren't fully living in our purpose. And, you know, we felt this itch to want more. Mm-hmm. You know, my husband actually has been through himself through 14 different industries.
Wow.
Because he was just trying to find where it was that he was just meant to be. And you know, started businesses, we failed at businesses, we've been successful at businesses, and, you know, we were going to franchise with a coffee shop, we've been in network marketing, we've done a lot of different things, and had a lot of success and failure through all of that. But, you know, what really brought me to where I'm at right now is, you know, a lot of pain, because I truly believe that when I tell, you know, my students, my clients, my audience, is that your previous pain points are your current selling points.
Oh, that's good.
You know? And oftentimes the things that we've walked through, you know, it's a good indication that those are the things that we're meant to speak to, we're meant to really, you know, hone in on and, you know, minister and bless other people in the season that they're in so that it avoids pain in their lives. And so for me, that was what it was for me. I walked through so much of that financial turmoil and making those poor decisions and not knowing how to handle our finances and not understanding that, you know, how to market myself or how to put myself out there, how to sell, you know,
right.
All those things that are very important. And I have this really bad stigma around selling. So a lot of the years that I was in business, I kind of was like this to selling.
Yes.
My husband is a sale. He came out of the womb selling. I think he, you know, sold his mom on, you know, breastfeeding. He just was like, that's like how he's just out of the womb, you know? But that was me. And I struggled with that. And so being in business has really caused me to get outside of my comfort zone and personally develop myself.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's been this amazing journey, and I'm so blessed to serve the community that I have in front of me. And I always say that I serve well the person that's in front of me, you know, the spirit of excellence, because I believe that if you can serve that person in front of you well, you can serve the mass as well. So
that is so awesome. I have to ask you this because, you know, because I think a lot of especially entrepreneurs, you know, they try so many different things. How did you find your niche? Like, when did you know, like, okay, I found what I'm supposed to do?
Yes. Well, that's a great question. I love that question because I love helping people discover that as well. And I, you know, for me, that started about 2 years ago. I was in a network marketing company. I was doing really well. Was recruiting really well. My business was growing. But for me, I felt like I was tired of dragging my kids to the park and to the library and to play dates and building these relationships offline, where actually, if you met me in person, it would be, you know, surprising to know that I'm actually kind of an introvert. I like to be home quite a bit of time. I simplify my life a lot because I like to be home a lot. And so I didn't want to be out 5 days a week prospecting and adding names to my contact list. And it really was something that I was like, I love what I'm doing, but I want to bring it online.
Yeah.
So originally that was my thought, is that I, you know, we started really getting in touch with people that were doing that. We're building online brands. We're, you know, I was exposed a few years back to just online marketers. And I was like, so mesmerized by this idea of building a business online.
Yeah.
And so I got connected with some amazing mentors and people. I started going live. That was actually kind of where I really found my voice and got some clarity. And I know that you have that similar story, Natasha. It's just like live just does it for you.
Yes.
It's like this, it's addicting, because one of the reasons why is because as you're going, you start to see, you know what, that really didn't, I didn't see that fire on that one.
Right.
And I didn't feel it on this one.
Yeah.
And you just start to kind of feel that energy that certain things light you up and other things, not so much.
Right.
And that's what I saw, is that I started talking about everything. I mean, and it wasn't things that I wasn't knowledgeable in. I talked about things that I knew about,
right?
You know, whether it was my kids' love languages or, you know, just, you know, my relationship with my husband and how we make it work being both entrepreneurs and, you know, all those things that I, from my own experience, like I said, those previous pain points and the things that I had done well and mastered, I wanted to share part of that journey. And so that's what I did. And I took people along for that journey. And along the way, I was connected to some amazing influencers, including Danelle Delgado and Nadia Melton.
Yes.
And I got to interview them at the beginning of last year, live on Periscope, which is kind of where we were hanging out. That was the hub back then. And so before Facebook Live took over the world, but I interviewed them, and I began to see that I got clarity just interviewing people in different niches. I've interviewed bloggers. I interviewed psychiatrists. I interviewed different people in different fields. And I said, you know what? I'm really drawn to this online business world. This is where it just comes naturally for me.
Right.
I loved marketing already. I had already been in marketing for many, many years. My first business was when I was 18 in network marketing. So it was just, you know, a lot of that experience already coming to that head.
Right.
And then I got hooked up with an influencer that shared me out on a broadcast one time. And I remember that was the one broadcast where 350 people jumped on that broadcast.
Wow.
And I was like, oh boy, you know, and at that time I was having two or three people jump on live with me, and I was just trucking along, and every single day, that was the thing, is I showed up every single day, regardless of how many people came on. There would be people that no people got on the broadcast, there would be five people in the broadcast, but I just showed up and delivered content every single day, and that day was the day that changed it. You know, that was the day I really found my people, because that person brought in their audience, and I really discovered, I was like, oh, they're my people, they're my people, I found them, you know. So that was kind of how it all started, and it was, it's just been a wild ride.
That is so powerful. I love hearing your story, because as I'm listening to your story, this is my story as well.
Yes.
So it's so powerful. And could you just speak to us about this, like a side note, because I'm so passionate about people, you know, just coming out their comfort zone and trying this online business world, right? Could you just speak to them real quick about the importance of live video and why they should go live?
Yes, this is one area that I'm really passionate about as well, because I feel like so many people, maybe they look at people who've been going live for a while, they have experience with it, so they're looking at their chapter 22 and comparing it to their chapter 1 or 2, and I think that happens in a lot of things in life. You know, we tend to compare ourselves to, you know, we look at the person with a six-figure launch, you know, and we don't realize they've got a massive team behind them, and they've spent $20,000 in Facebook ads, and we don't see all the behind-the-scenes stuff. Right. And so I think that happens with us with Facebook Live as well, or live video, is that we tend to compare ourselves. And I was just talking about this today, about how, you know, we really have this tendency, especially in the social media world that we live in Instagram, you know, world that we live in, that we want it to all look perfect. We want it to be pretty and put together and make sure that nothing is out of place. And, you know, make sure that, you know, there's no distractions, and the kids don't come in, and we don't have anything in our teeth, and we just want to make sure everything's perfect. And then we don't do anything because we just are waiting for perfect. And, you know, it's like, it's just better sometimes if it's done, not perfect, if it's put out there, because you will improve, you know. And I always say, it's like, do it once, you know, just do it once, you know, one step at a time. Some people are like, I can't write I can't start a blog because I can't commit to two or three times a week. It's like, just write one blog, commit to one blog, you know, commit to one video, commit to one live video, you know, put one video up on YouTube. Like, it doesn't have to be a massive commitment right away. And I think that that's where, for me, I just knew when I found live video, it was my thing. And for, you know, for a lot of people, people realize that with live video, it accelerates that rate at which people need to like and trust.
That's right.
And I mean, we have seen it like never before that people are buying like that on live video. I mean, we are connecting with people. They get our vibe. They are attracted to us.
That's right.
They connect with our story, with our vision, and they buy immediately.
That's right.
And it's been really powerful for me to see that firsthand in my business, but I'm also so many others' businesses at different places in their brands.
Right.
You know, I've seen people at the very, very beginning build a brand from scratch using live video. People who have had brands for years that are ditching a ton of other marketing things they've been doing and focusing on live video because they see the power in it.
Right.
And so I'm a big advocate for people just getting out there and getting themselves out there in any way that looks like for them.
Right.
But definitely live video is, you know, I mean, Facebook itself has poured $50 million into this platform. Right. It's not going anywhere. This is it. So
absolutely. All right, we're going to shift a little bit because seriously, like, we're passionate about this subject, obviously. And if you guys want to know more about live video, and, you know, Jess is definitely the expert, but so we can definitely do something else if you guys are interested in this subject. But we're going to shift a little bit and talk about the family, because this is where it gets a little bit, because I'm in the same situation with Jess. You know, I'm a stay-at-home mom, you know, I have six children, you know, so we're going to shift a little bit. Just so I want you to just share with us, what are some of the challenges for you, you know, being at home with the kiddos, because you have three of them under the age of five, you guys, isn't she amazing? So give me some of the challenges that you're facing being at home with the kids, and how are you overcoming them?
Yes. Well, you know, it's so funny because I even hear one of my little guys out here, like, you know, getting up and walking out. And it's like, you know, this is the reality of working at home as a mom. And, you know, I often say it's like, you know, we, this whole like balance thing is a myth. You know, like we think that we need to have every single day perfectly balanced.
Hey, buddy.
I know.
That's life right there.
This is life right here.
Yep, it is. I won't be surprised if my son don't come down as well.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. So anyway, we just, you know, from the beginning, I said, you know, they're my priority.
That's
and
right.
That, you know, not every single day is going to look perfectly balanced.
That's right.
You know, it's not going to be like, you know, oh, I spent 2 hours with the kids and 2 hours on my business, and 2 hours, you know, on the housework. And sometimes there is imbalance,
that's
you know,
right.
on a day-to-day basis. But overall, over a season of life, you know, I once heard an influencer, an expert say that, you know, if you're looking at your life overall, you know, taking the trip to Disney World and spending, you know, $5,000 is out of balance.
Right.
You know, going on a book tour for 40 days straight or for, you know, being on a massive, you know, in a mode of launch, you can't sustain that over a period
right.
of time. It's going to be imbalanced for a little while.
That's right.
And for me, it's just there are seasons where it seems imbalanced, but overall, you know, over the year, over the month, over the week, I'm making sure that I'm touching on the most important priorities in my life.
That's right.
And then I'm making sure that I keep the main things,
right.
you know, and that I don't, you know, I realize that there may be seasons where my business may slow and they may grow slower than other people.
Right.
But I'm focusing on the big thing.
That's
main
right.
thing. And
That's
so,
right.
It is a struggle. It's absolutely a struggle. It's a struggle sometimes with time management and,
right.
you know, things are unpredictable. You've got sick kids and you've got things that come up and you've
right.
got, you know, babies that wake up from naps and
right.
you've got, you know, things that happen. And so it's real. I always say blessed is the flexible, you know, blessed are the flexible. They should not be broken.
That's
you
right.
know, it's like we just gotta, you know, stay flexible, give ourselves a ton of grace in those seasons
That's
and
right.
really understand that, you know, ultimately we're not damaging our kids.
That's
our
right.
kids are, they are, they're going to be okay. They're going to admire and learn a lot about work ethic
That's right.
and, you know, about personal development. And they're going to learn so much from your journey of watching you fail and get back up and watching you try and put yourself out there
yes.
and try scary stuff. They're
right.
going to watch that and learn more about those life lessons from watching you do it as a mama or as a dad,
right.
you know, far more than you talk about it. You
Absolutely.
Know, so they're going to watch it in your life and they're going to learn so much about that just from those life lessons of watching you do it. So.
Absolutely. I can definitely attest to that because when I started putting myself out on social media and Periscope is where I started, just like that's where Jess started
yeah.
as well. You know, my kids watched me for a while, you know,
yeah.
Alexis came on right on board with me, but the other ones just watched me. And eventually they wanted to do it as well. And just like Jess was saying, like they watch you and they're like, okay, I'm going to see if mom's going to stick to this. I'm going to see if this is just a phase. And
yes.
then before you know it, I'm catching my 6 and 8 year old in their room on the laptop making videos.
Yes.
And it's crazy because it's not even a gift that I knew was in the children, but because they saw me do it, I got out of my comfort zone. And now here's a gift within them that's surfacing. It's just amazing.
Absolutely.
So it's so worth it. I mean, it's work. It's the struggle is real, but
that's
it
right.
is so
that's
worth
right.
it.
That's right. That's
okay.
right.
Okay.
You know, and it's a powerful thing too, because Natasha, as you know, you know, oftentimes we're working so hard as parents because we want our ceiling to be their floor.
Right.
You know, we want to give them an opportunity to have a head start
That's
in
right.
whatever that may be, you know, and giving that personal development, starting that early on. So they're not having to be the ones suffering in their 20s and 30s, you
That's
know,
right.
and 50s and 60s like
right.
people are. So it's really tackling it and really making sure that we are gaining that ground for them. So that when they're ready to step out, you know, and do the things that are scary to them, that they've gone through a lot more probably
right.
than most people have in their entire lifetime, you
right.
know, even as children. So
right.
it's exciting to watch.
Absolutely. So I would imagine, Jess, you know, having 3 little kiddos, that you've mastered some type of system in your home. Because,
yes.
I mean, you have an amazing business. You're crushing it right now online. So tell us, give us some strategies here, some different system that you use to be able to keep that harmony in your home.
Yes. Oh, I'm all about those systems. Like, if it can be created, I will create a system for it. I just love me some systems. And, you know, I think that something that you're doing over and over and over again is usually a good indication to you that you need to make a system around it.
Right.
And so the little things like, you know, going grocery shopping and meal planning and laundry, everything can be made into a system. When I hired my housekeeper, for example, we have somebody that comes once a week that mm-hmm. comes and helps us around the house, and she does a little bit of laundry, helps us with that, but she does about 2 loads of laundry while she's here, and as a family of 5, that's not enough. So
right.
every single day when I wake up in the morning, I get the coffee started, I pull, you know, put in a load of laundry. And then when that one's done, it beeps at me. I move it over into the dryer. When that beeps at me, I take it out, I fold it, and I put it away immediately. So every single day, I'm doing a load of laundry. And most of the time, even in crazy seasons like this, I mean, I admit things get left behind and behind and things like that.
Right.
But most of the time, we're keeping up on that. Every Sunday night, I have a system where I do the same thing every Sunday evening. I do my meal plan. I go through my, you know, my recipes. I make my meal plan for the week. I do my grocery shopping online to pick up on Monday morning.
Perfect.
So that I don't have to take and spend that hour and a half in the grocery store. And I like it because once you've gone grocery shopping online once, Walmart makes a system for me and throws it in a favorites pile. And then I just put that favorites pile into my cart and I've got it.
So awesome.
It takes me, you know, maybe 20 minutes to go shopping rather than the normal hour and a half with 3 kids.
Right.
And so that is a system. And even in your business, you know, one thing that I do once a week is on a Sunday evening as well. I usually take all of my husband's receipts. It's usually my husband's receipts because he mm-hmm. travels for his business. If you've got any sort of business where you have a lot of receipts, maybe you eat out with clients, maybe you connect with people over coffee meetings, anything like that, you can put into, you know, a pile of receipts. And every single Sunday, I scan those receipts and drop mm-hmm. them into my Dropbox.
Right.
So it's already in my Dropbox at the end of every single year, and I'm not having to go through this pile yeah. of receipts.
Right.
You know what I mean? That's like yeah. normally how our system is at the end of the year.
Yes, absolutely.
So we're stressing about taxes. So every single thing, if I can make it into a sustainable system. You know, I heard a quote once that said that don't build a, you know, 2-lane system if you want a 6-lane highway business.
Good.
You know, it's really hard sometimes to think of future and how you want to go, where you want to go as a business. But I think it's important to realize that part of that vision is creating sustainability. And it's very hard to sustain certain things without putting systems in place. And so if you have a team member that keeps asking the same question, if you have, you know, new recruits that are coming onto into your business, for example, and you are answering the same question over and over again, make a video and send
right.
it to them, you know,
right.
make it once and send it over and over and over to them, or a thank you video to your customers or clients, whatever it is, everything can be systemized. So I love some systems, and I would encourage you, if you have anything in your life that's really causing a lot of headache for you, that's taking a lot of time, that's something that you do a lot over and over and over again, figure out a way that you can systemize it.
That is awesome. When I first heard you talk about systems, I was like, oh my goodness, especially about the grocery shopping and the laundry. I mean, I was yeah. like, this is phenomenal stuff. So thank you for sharing that again. Okay,
yes.
So tell us, what is the best advice? And if you guys have any questions right now, it would be a great time to put your questions in the comments as
yeah.
we're getting ready for the last 3 questions here. What is the greatest advice that you could give our community, some women that's probably thinking about transitioning, you know, from that 9-to-5 and just coming into the home and just, you know, having that online business or that home-based business? What would be your best advice?
Yes. One of the things that I've worked with quite a few ladies who have made that transition from mm-hmm. either working full time or they feel like they have no time.
Mm-hmm.
They're looking at their schedule already and they're looking at extracurricular activities and the parent teacher conferences and the, you know, the maybe other obligations that they have. And they're going, I have nowhere in my schedule to possibly start or grow a business. And I hear that. And I definitely get that because when I started my business, my little guy was only 5 weeks old. And so I had a newborn and 2 kids under, you know, under 3. So I get that. But, you know, I really do think that the biggest advantage that you have as a working mom, maybe you work outside of the home, or a working parent, when you work outside of the home and you're ready to come home, is that you have already been used to structure within office hours. So you've been used to maybe, you know, working on being productive in a short amount of time, maybe in spurts of times. I encourage you to bring that into a home-based business, because a lot of the time what happens is we blend everything. You know, we say like, you know, oh, the couch is the same place that I read books to my babies. It's the same place that I work on my laptop and return emails. It's the same place that I watch Netflix with the husband. Like, everything is in that same spot on the couch. And oftentimes, as home business owners, we need to be wise about time blocking out office hours and really being, you know, treating our business like a business and not like a hobby. You know, it's really important that we say, okay, from 6 to 8 a.m., mommy is working, or from 1 to 3 p.m., mommy's working, 7 to 9 p.m., mommy's working. Those are usually my hours. So I will usually look at the week ahead, and I will say, okay, this is what days my husband's going out of town. This is the days that I, you know, I have some help coming in. These are the days that I've got some interviews or things set up that I need to get some help for. And so I just make sure that I'm structuring my days as if I have office hours. And then I treat them like that. I clock in, I clock out, in a sense. So I loved what you did on the five habits, the 50 minutes, because I think that's so good. You know, the 50 minutes, getting 50 minute time blocks, and just saying, you know what, for 50 minutes, I'm going to focus, a lot of focus on this task at hand, and really put my full focus, you know, put the earplugs in, you know, figure out, you know, the kids and things like that. There were a lot of days I got very creative with that. But ultimately, I think that treating it like a business is so, so important. And, you know, giving your business the attention that it deserves. And knowing that that's worthy of that, that's, you know, not feeling bad about that. So I make sure to separate those things. I make sure to say, when I'm with my business, I'm with my business. And I don't apologize for that. And when I'm with my kids, I'm absolutely with my kids, you know, and I want to make sure I'm with them and I'm focused on them. I'm pouring into them. And so, but that's, you know, working at home is that, that struggle. The struggle is real there. I get that. It is hard because you've got to be self-disciplined. You've got to be self-motivated. You've got to kick yourself in the booty sometimes and get things rolling. And the other thing is, too, is just bringing on help. You know, I think that as moms, especially, we take pride in, like, I got this. I can do it all. You know, and you can't. You can have it all, but you can't do it all.
That's right.
You need some help. And whether that looks like, one of the biggest, like, you know, sucker punches to my pride was taking on that housekeeper, because I said, you know what? No, I got this. I'm, nobody's going to clean my house like I do. Nobody's going to scrub my toilets. I'm going to scrub my own toilets. You know, like, it was beneath me. And I actually used to look up to people and think that they were stuck up for having a housekeeper. And I said, you know what? In this season of our life, we're both growing separate businesses. We've got young kids. This is what area of my life I need to delegate right now, so that I can focus on the things that matter, you know, so I can sit down and read a book to my babies and not worry about the laundry or worry about the dirty sink, you know? So getting help is so, so important. And so I really would encourage you, if you're bringing your business home, or if you're working at a home-based business, regardless of what area in your business you're in, I did this in the very, very beginning. It was the best decision I ever did. I hired a housekeeper when I wasn't even making money, because I knew it would free me up to focus on the things that only I could do. That's, you know, somebody else could do the load of laundry. Not anybody can just go live for me. That's, I need to be there.
That's right.
So, and I need to be with my clients. I need to be with my students. I need to be creating my content. Only I can do those things.
That's so good. So I hope you guys got that. That was a major nugget. So hire people that can do the things that you can do, but do the, you know, so you have room to be able to do the things that no one else can do but you. That's powerful. Right. That's a great mindset. Okay, so give us, Wayne Connor asked a question. He said, do you have any links or materials on systems, the systems that you've created? Because I think that's powerful. Do you have any links?
You know, it's funny, Wayne, that you say that, because I'm actually putting together a training right now doing that, because I get this question answered a lot. So I will do that. I'm in the works for that. So stay tuned on that. I'll say that. Yes.
So as we're talking about it, because I know everybody's curious, because you keep saying your business. Could you just share with us what your business is, Jess?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. So I know that whole thing of like the online, you know, online business, you know, marketing strategist, like what do you do? So I, you know, when I first got started going live, I had my network marketing business, but like I said, it wasn't what I was super duper passionate about. It wasn't like I could do this every day, all day. And you know, this is like my thing. So I really went in the beginning of last year, I had people reaching out to me that were growing businesses, that were in marketing businesses online, that wanted to use live video, but they weren't sure about all the technical side of things. Like, how do you go live? How do you run a broadcast? You know, so I taught what I knew. I taught, you know, how to create content, how to structure a broadcast, because it's for me, oftentimes it's that thing that you think comes very effortless to you. It's the thing that other people are going, but how? Like, how do you do that? And like, and they just don't understand how. But tell me the X, Y, Z. Tell me the 1, 2. Tell me the steps. And you're going, but it's so easy. So sometimes you're like, how? Why is this such a big deal? You know.
Right.
And so for a while, I didn't understand why other people just didn't get this. Like, just go live, push the button. You know.
Right.
But I started to take on, in almost kind of an experimental state, I just started to take on one-on-one clients. And I started to do like this little 4-week thing with them where I taught them how to go live. And I taught them how to, you know, it was called Monetize My Scope. That's why I started doing it at the beginning of last year. And I just started to teach them how to sell on you know, live video, how to do that, how to go through that process. And then in April, I really wanted to get my, you know, reach more people, help more people in a shorter amount of time. So I created a course called Livestream Academy, and that was about just going live. And at the time, Facebook Live was just coming on the scene in April of last year.
Yeah, I mean, it was.
Just come on the scene.
Yep.
So mine was for one of the first trainings on Facebook Live, on Periscope. Both. I mean, I taught both inside the academy and both inside the course. But not just that. I also taught funnels because I had started, I started a freebie. I did a downloadable freebie at the beginning of last year, you know, watched the 50 YouTube videos, was completely self-taught. I went through that whole stuff of banging my head against the wall on that sort of thing. So I wanted to create something that was not just, you know, okay, this is how you go live, but this is how people to get people over to funnel. This is how people to get people onto your email list. What do you do once they're on your email list? You know, how do you nurture that list? Things like that. So I just started to do things that I was just learning myself, you know, in the previous season.
Right.
And that was very popular. That was a great course. We had live Q&As throughout the whole thing. It was fantastic. And then I did another launch at that same academy in August.
Right.
And, very, you know, just really, really great lessons. You know, a lot of ups and downs in that, and learning what was my thing, what I love to do, and what really made me tick. And I realized that a lot of what made me tick was live video, like being live with people, not necessarily recorded, but being live, being there with people and connecting with my audience and really helping them. So I have taken on, I'm not anymore, but I was, you know, at the end of last year, also taking on some one-on-one clients and really helping them to narrow down and get specific and get a marketing strategy in place and, you know, launch products and things like that. So it is, it's been really fun because for me, in so many ways, it was a kind of an accidental business. Right. I didn't seek out to just start this business.
Right.
It wasn't something that I, you know, sought out to, you know, have, you know, speaking engagements or things like I didn't do that on purpose.
Right.
But it was this thing that I had this voice that had been so suppressed for so long that when it came off, when the lid came off, it was like God just put me into that place of favor with people.
Yes.
But it was like, this is what you're supposed to do.
Yes.
And opportunities opened up like crazy, you know, and it was neat because the people that I interviewed last year ended up being the people that, you know, were interviewing me now. So it was like, it was just a really neat thing to have happen. So
that is so awesome. You said something and I just want to talk a little bit about it because I don't want anyone to miss this. You said that you were teaching you are putting a course together, things that you learned the previous season. Okay, so I think a lot of us, we feel like, okay, we got to get it perfect. We have to master this skill, and then we can start teaching and selling. But that's not right. what Jess did. Jess learned it, right. and she was already teaching it. So, because a lot of people feel like, you know, I got to be perfect. But Nadia Melton taught me this, and it freed me. She said, you're going to be bad before you're good. You're going to be good before you're great. You're going to be great before you're exceptional, right. which means it gives you permission not to be perfect. Like, you don't have to get it perfect before you can actually, you know, get out that comfort zone. And I think it's through with your story, mine's very similar, that, you know, we just got uncomfortable. We just kept doing the thing that scared us, not knowing what it was going to lead to. But the more we did it and you were consistent, that's part of her story as well. She was consistent. She showed up every single day and then the doors began to open. So I think that is just so phenomenal.
That's
so you can just talk a little bit about that.
Yes, that is something that, you know, it freaked me a lot too, to hear that, you know, I was even listening to Grant Cardone's 10X Growth Con, and this guy has been in, you know, the media industry for, you know, years and years and years. He has clients like Steve Harvey, you know, I mean, this guy is brilliant. And he was saying, I'm a flawed expert. You know,
that.
I am somebody who is learning the journey along the way. And, you know, sometimes you just got to find that avenue that, you know what, I want to be the expert in this field. You learn a skill set, you master it, and then you teach it, you know. And this is what I did. This is something that I, you know, I was making sure that I was mastering this thing and really delivering incredible intentional strategic content,
right?
And that is the thing that I would encourage you with, is that if you don't know that yet,
right,
it's just oftentimes, like I said, it's sometimes the previous version of yourself. Mm-hmm. You know, sometimes that person that you're meant to reach, you maybe walk through a season, you know, it's like the people or sometimes it's people want what you have.
That's
in
right.
the current season that you're in. You know, I think a lot of the times the reason why people are so drawn to you, Natasha, is that you've, like, raised these incredible children. Like, you have raised these incredible kids.
Thank
and so
you.
People see this testimony, this thing on your life, mm-hmm. that it's like, I want what you have.
Mm-hmm.
Teach me this,
right.
you know? And if you're getting that from people, just like what you did with this group, a lot of the times you need to pay attention.
Right.
You need to listen to what people are asking from you.
Right.
You pay attention to the things that you're passionate about. You need to pay attention to the things that, you know, that lights you up, and that the previous things that just make you upset, things
right.
that just are those cries of injustice in your heart that you
right.
feel like, that's the thing I need to speak to.
Right.
You know, for example, if you feel like, you know what, I hate that people are in debt. I hate that people are, you know, they're bound in debt. They're caught. They're just, you know, they're in bondage and they don't even realize it. And you feel fire from that because you've walked through
right,
that. You've had
right.
victory in that.
Yes.
Maybe you have gotten out of debt and you can now speak to that area of, you know, you may not have the, you know, you may not be a CPA, you
right.
may not be Dave Ramsey, but Dave Ramsey started by putting out consistent
content
on a daily basis
yes.
when him and his wife were still suffering financially,
yep.
you know? And so I really just encourage you that no matter what season you're in, you can
mm-hmm.
help the person behind you. And I sometimes liken it to an analogy of like a mom,
yes.
you know, oftentimes with young moms, we're asking for the, you know, how to get our kids to sleep through the night, how to get our kids, you know, what about breastfeeding, all about these things, you know, we're going to the mom just a few steps ahead of
That's
us.
Right.
We're going to the mom that maybe has the 1 or 2 year old and asking them about, you know, those breastfeeding, you know, months, even though it was just a few months ago for her.
Perfect.
But we are asking the person that is just a few steps ahead of us, because
right.
oftentimes they're actually more relatable
mm-hmm.
to the person who is so far ahead. Maybe the mom who's got, like, you know, she's the seasoned grandma.
Right.
And she's like, I've got this thing in the bag. I've been doing this for 40 years,
right.
you know. Oftentimes, we can't fully connect or relate to that person.
That's right.
And it's the same way with business. You know, the people that need you are oftentimes, they're just a few steps behind you in the process and the journey. And they need that ability to connect and relate with you
wow.
and say that you have that fresh in your mind. You have
so
that
good.
Struggle fresh in your mind. You know how it feels to, you know, to go through that, to walk through that.
Right.
You can feel it in your gut because it was so recent.
Right.
And I think that's why I've been able to continue to create content in that place, because
right.
it's a continual journey.
Right.
It's like,
that's right.
you know, sometimes I'll watch those videos from a year and a half ago and I'm taking notes, you
right.
know, because it's like, you were in it,
that's
you know,
right.
you came out of that victorious. And so I just encourage you to walk through those things, be victorious in those areas, that you help the person behind you, that you
yes.
help save them time, cut out the learning curve for them.
Awesome, awesome. So how can we, so I know that I'm sure there's people watching now and they heard your story and they know what you do now. So tell them how to connect with you and also share about your group, because I'm part of your group and it's phenomenal. So I would love for you to share that out so, you know, people can, you know, head to that group as well.
Absolutely. So you can find me here on Facebook at facebook.com/JessWinnett.tv. And you can also find me within my group. I'm pretty active in there, Women Winning. And sorry, guys, it is for the ladies. But it's just really helping you to win in every area of your life. You know, recently, it's been a passion of mine to not just help you win in business, but to really help you thrive get out of survival mode in every area of your life.
So
you know, whether it's your finances, whether it's your business, whether it's your relationships or your mindset, you know, really checking those things and getting those things in order so that we can thrive as a whole person. And so it's, you know, it's so important because I really believe that so often we're focused on, you know, and I think that we're in the same camp, Natasha, where we're all about that personal development,
yes.
You know, and that leads to so many other areas unlocking so many things for us in our life, you know, but it's like we focus a lot of times on, you know, getting people free financially. You know, getting people free. I want to get you free financially. I'm going to help you have time freedom and financial freedom. Well, it's all about that financial freedom.
Right.
But we really want to help people get free inside.
That's
you
right.
Know, really help people get free as a whole person.
That's right.
You know, because if you operate as a whole person, as a healed person,
that's right.
You win in those other areas of your life.
Absolutely.
It just happens for you.
Absolutely. So. Because it really starts, it stems down to mindset. You know what I mean?
Yes.
It's really you teaching minds and you teaching people, and that's what people want. People want that freedom in their mind. So absolutely. So I'm so glad you're branching out because I know you have so much more on this journey as you, you know, continue this journey. You have so much more. So as we're wrapping up, if you guys don't have any questions, if you have questions, put it right now because I want to hear from Jess her final thoughts, you know, as we wrap up this beautiful interview. So Jess, thank you so much for coming into Excellent Fams to share, you know, about your business and your family and how you're able to keep all that in harmony. If you don't have any questions, just give us one last final thought to take with us.
Yes. Well, I, you know, my biggest thing is that, you know, my hope is that you're empowered to step into, you know, your purpose, because ultimately there are people out there that need you and your story and what you have to offer. And, you know, we cannot afford, the world can't afford for us to play small, you know? And so we have to step into our purpose so we can help and give permission to those that need us to step into theirs.
That's right.
You know, we give that permission to other people when we do. So I just encourage you to, you know, discover what that is, you know, and discover, you know, why you've been put here, because you've got big things to do.
Absolutely. So. That is so good. So you guys check Jess out at her private Facebook group. It's called Women Winning. And I love to share because, you know, a lot of people are like, well, why do you share other people's group? Because success, there's not a shortage of it. You know what I mean? And we want all women winning. You know, we're in this together. So I could share, you know, Jess's group out. And I encourage you to go and just be in her group, you know, get value in her group, add value in her group as well, because we're all in this together just trying to grow, you know what I mean? As a person, as a whole, you know? So that's all we have for you guys. Thank you so much, Jess, first and foremost, for just coming out tonight
Thank
and just giving us your time. We know you're a busy mom. So we
thank
appreciate
you.
That. And everyone who hopped on tonight, thank you so much for joining us. And until next time with Excellent Families, bye-bye.
Bye.